I had to give what I gave. I had to give up fucking what, Nightlane for this man? That shit crazy. I'm gonna start him off on his first game in a motherfucking mud weekend league, or should I did season, but I sit him attacker right on in mud weekend. Watch what I tell you. This shit gonna be, it's gonna be loud, but I feel like he gonna be a good card though. I feel like it. And it's not keeping up with me right now. Let me go back to this card right quick. See what I compare him to Josh Norman's replay card. Let's see what we got here in the bag. Alright. Not too much of a big difference, but speed and Josh Norman catch better than he knew it. Alright, man coverage better. Alright. Let's get this game under away. Away. Wrong thing. My bad. My weekend underway. Hopefully I don't play nobody that runs that cover four. About to go with that. About to go with that. It's about to be crazy. Bloom Blaze. I do it for the honor. I do it for the life. Man, this is a low. Charles. Alright, his top three. I might call that team my top three. As you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Probably gonna go and close that out. Well, hell no. I'm saying.
Now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
It might be cold though. It might be wild. Oh. Oh!
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Fix my settings right quick. Speed.
Catch there brings up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches.
No, man. Should pick that one.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long?
You tackle and they go down on the spot. Xavier Rose with the save, though. With the save. In terms of
yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
McCown looking to throw, and this is going to be incomplete.
And that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be.
I've got. I picked up AJ Green a couple of days ago when he first came out.
Completion to set up fourth. Okay, look at this.
Not to mention it.
To be found there on the sidelines.
Taking a chance right here.
On the opening drive. Here's McCown to throw. As this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete.
All right, man.
A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the ball will go over on downs on short side of the field. 3.5 to go, first quarter. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Give him 3 on first down.
I say, I am supporting True out there in that Madden League tournament, you know what I'm saying? I ain't even keeping tabs on it, but
say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action. Hit him over.
Oh!
This one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Set that boy wild.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Going on first is Wentz. Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. DeMarcus Ware leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of 6. Now Wentz throwing on second down. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
Dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
Too fast for him, coach. Too fast for him.
LaDainian Tomlinson from 6 yards away. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. That's fielded in the end zone.
Boy, I hear wow, dude.
Football 101 tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light play. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
And this one caught by Cameron Brain. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 18 big yards on that one, and a Miami first.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, having your eyes in the right place.
Ah. Zay Rose with that tackle. Come on, baby.
Go down. They got him for a sack. Brandon Graham. Able to drop him for a loss of 4. On second down, here's McKell.
I don't know that my boys catch that pig, man.
And it's third down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
He's gonna look down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Rashawn Jones. And the return stops.
And we got our rage quitter. Right, quick. One right, quick. Man, I said they out here wild. Pow. Say, give it that spit. I said, I know. Man, these load screens. It'll take forever.
Brandon Gunn, Charles Davis, ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game. And you're a big player in today's game as
top
well.
Okay,
let's get
okay,
the party
okay.
started. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This is fielded a couple yards deep.
Ow!
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30.
No, I always got to start off like that to see if we can get some good shaking or bacon. Shubba!
Rushing the passer?
We did, and how about now?
Oh boy, he's expanded his game in a big way. Really does a great job in the run game now. Using his length, using his leverage to hold the point of his
how? He getting blocked! Alright, man.
Michael Strahan, able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of three.
Ooh, the sitting up here getting blocked and tackling at the same time.
This is third and long. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. A big gain of 39 on third.
Okay, what can't DeSean Jackson do? All right, we know
that's that burner.
Saw another one there. Also gets involved in the return game. And he could break big plays like that. We've seen him do it throughout his NFL career.
We have. What are you thinking of anything in particular?
Yeah, I'm still remembering a certain Giants punter not following orders. And DeSean Jackson made that big-time return all the way back for a game winner in that one. I still remember seeing the looks of disbelief on the Giants sideline.
Shotgun now for Wentz. Room here to run.
I'm slow. Ah, that one of his slides.
The 30 down to the 25. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. Fresh set of downs here. Throwing now is Wentz.
Man, he got off that block that quick, bro. Come on, bro. Ain't no way. I'll give him that. Yes, he jumped the reader, right?
First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Young on first and 10. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away.
He held on to it. Oh, man, come on.
The ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a...
No one of these, dude. It's got to chew the clock.
On the run, this is Jackson. And this time, not as successful. Get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Gave him that. I even switched out of the coverage here.
Third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Dude, that's not a glitch, bro. It was all right there. Oh, come on.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return.
I'm trying to see how they tackle him on back turn.
25 at the 24-yard line. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them,
so they made me truck and I didn't truck.
Once it threw the interception.
Oh, yeah, I'm tripping, man.
Here we go with second and seven. Now wins. Eluding the pressure right.
Dude up here glitching his damn line, bro. Come on with the bullshit.
In there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the Scrambler or the Dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves.
He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes as a gain of 37 on third down. Wins. Looking for his running back, and he's got
Michael Vick phone, man. Here we go. Here we go.
You look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Now they try the right side here, and he'll be knocked down sideways, right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Young man, walk play action.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go through a zone blitz scheme. Get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out and he ended up with an interception.
But he's running back ain't falling on that.
Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Looking to throw on second down. Young. And that is incomplete here. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You drop an eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Let's go. On third down, that's Jackson.
The glitching, dude. I missed the whole fucking tackle.
But a nice little game. That'll be good for six, but now it's fourth down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
And this one is right down Broadway. And the lead moves to 10-0. So it's a seven-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic Oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. David. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11. To throw, it's Wentz. He's going to fire one deep, middle. They got his man, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to...
Threw the ball, bro. Now I can't throw the damn ball? Come on, man. Let me throw the damn ball.
As it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Now Wentz.
All right, man. That's crazy. Yeah, there's some major BS right there.
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
And it's complete. Over the middle to Clark. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. They'll run it now out of the gun. And unable to get downhill there, so take this up to about the 37. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
But when you go from second to four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
What? Oh, heck no. There we go. There we go.
Final seconds of the first half. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead.
That's a lead that excites a team.
There is no way that's possible.
Yeah, able to extend that lead. And you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends. Good point.
Why does Larry always do that? He just stops talking. But let's go play the third quarter. I'm psyched. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know, the special teams coordinators. They sell.
Not going to pull a cheater. They got where is it? Anybody finished that week one replay daily list?
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready
to go.
Let's go,
man. Let's go.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll run it now out of the gun. Broke a tackle, but not much room there ultimately. Just up past the 25 and no further. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
I once had a defensive player in the NFL tell me, if I beat and dominate the guy across from me, I'm helping my team. Well, winning one-on-one battles is always a part of the game. But when you have good team defense, as we just saw there, one broken tackle, but he didn't get away because the rest of the guys arrived to put him on the ground.
To throw on second down, Cunningham escaping the pressure right, looking sideline, incomplete. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time.
They're looking in the mirror.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
To throw on third down. Cunningham
trying to take that,
and it's intercepted.
And where I go,
near the 32, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That was third down defensively. They were just hoping to make a play and get off the field, get their offense on. Instead, they did one better, pick it off, take it into the end zone.
No, they did what you said, they got off.
They did get off. They're gonna have to come right back on.
They're gonna come right back on, but happily, right? They put the ball in the end zone. That's the way you start a game. That's the way you set the tone.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage left defensively. Throwing to start the drive. Cunningham. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong arm.
Damn, boy.
Put it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball.
Man, he wasn't supposed to outrun them.
Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Second down following the incompletion. Swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming. the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. On third down, Cunningham. And an alley to run. And now the ball's out.
Ball back.
And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. In their locker room, they've got a sign that says defense wins championships. And Charles, they pointed to that this week, said that has to be us looking good early.
I like how you saw that because of the bold letters, right? You saw the emphasis that they place on that and what they believe in. And for them, it's every single snap. So it's not just a matter of getting to the quarterback and knocking the ball free. They're trying to read when that ball's going to come free. As soon as those hands separate the throw,
Michael Vick, he's going to go. And touchdown.
Let's go, man. Let's go.
Michael Vick. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball.
They let him block it.
But he will not be able to bring this one back. And the extra point attempt, unsuccessful.
Well, there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing, and we had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry. It's just one point. Oh, my. Those coaches see a point is gold to them because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's what I was just going to say. First quarter, we'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
Still can't believe they told the head coach to relax.
Bad move. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
They'll set up the screen with Davis, and he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner. Everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense is able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You know that man was across the line. And he's denied. Alright, Charles Schwartz saved.
Here on fourth down.
Oh, good. Shouldn't do this.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw.
Got him!
Spot, he gets him down for a loss of 5.
I said, we're going to win. We're
good. And they'll start this drive.
So you the one and the one in their life. You the one. One up here now. Hey, good blocks. Good blocks. Oh, and Michael Vick fumble. He got it right, man. Ah. Yeah, Michael Vick, you probably about to go, buddy. Too many fumbles. Ah, he should have fumbled.
Opportunistic by the defense. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game.
So you don't want to run every night.
With the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
A dump off for Davis. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll lead here to a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
On third down.
Get him!
It's Davis, and he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively.
So you gotta work. There you go.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're gonna go for it.
Here we go.
They're gonna try and throw. Flush to his right. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off. 27.
I will not let you pass.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
Well, you gotta run. This nigga Mike, come.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Looking for the end.
Forced it in there.
Intercepted. Picked up by Anderson Dejo. And to the 12, that's where it
starts.
The return is halted at the 12-yard line.
The good old cover three defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football when it's thrown, and pick it off, just as we saw there.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right, on the run, he'll let this go deep. Oh, this is taken in.
Oh, Rashad.
And he makes it all the way down to the 31.
Gave up on me, big dog. Says you gotta.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
Maybe missed the tackle. That was a secure tackler. Missed the tackle. All right, man. Fix your mechanics.
Great play there. 31 yards. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one
thing
we learned in our time in this game. Yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball, too, right?
Oh, without a doubt, you need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken at his 4. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. He finds an opening past the 40.
I said, make it work, 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 very good. You're the one I want in my life, y'all. Ah, Bo Jackson.
They have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide.
Man, y'all for real? Ah, man. Hey, bail this man out.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run.
Get him!
Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about a different style of running in order to get this guy going.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end,
we get it in the mirror
and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Looking to throw, Cunningham, and he connects with Ertz. And he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Throwing on first down. Cunningham eluding the pressure.
Yeah!
This time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
You gotta eat to survive, baby.
Into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. Looking to throw on second down. Cunningham.
Burnt.
That's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown.
Huh. Come on, bro.
DeSean Jackson from 21 yards away. And the Eagles are back within a score. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes from the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. So out now comes the offense back onto the field.
But they just let dude burn everybody on defense, and I got straight fast feet on defense. This is crazy.
Now they try the right side here. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop
I got
the
it in the mirror.
Smother it, just as they did on that last play.
And now here's a carry heading left. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of two, now third down. And the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
They'll try a little trickery here on the end zone. And he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15.
Get it off.
It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The punter wing is on as he sends this one away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. And they call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Shift together here from the D-line. On first and 10, Cunningham. Escaping the pressure right.
Let's go! That boy Norman sees all, he knows all. Yeah!
So that is three interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but yeah, let's be honest, we're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next year?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here, but he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Second down now after the incompletion. To throw is Wentz. Buying time to his left. Johnson with a first down and more. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Wentz now on first down. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson.
Damn, man, that was a good throw, but shit, I didn't know this was going to catch up.
Back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly to send the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger wrap, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. And he'll give it here to his running back. Even with him busting through the contact, he'll still be stopped just inside the 35. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this.
Oh, man, you call a timeout, bro. You picked your defensive play.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. And his kick is absolutely perfect. and that'll push the lead up to 8. So they get the 3, increase their lead to close out the half.
Excellent way to end the drive, going to the locker room with a little bit of extra momentum after adding 3 to their total.
Short kick, running up middle, take it down. We have hit halftime, still 2 more. And apparently that's all, Larry. So much for the halftime report. We'll see you in the postgame. We're ready to get to the third quarter. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This one taken just inside the 10. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
They don't know what they want, coach.
Now I think they go a little bit deeper.
Can you...
In the first half, that worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. They go play action here on first down. Flush to his right. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. So the youngster able to use the legs to pick up the first.
And one of my pet peeves when they see this guy play, when Carson Wentz takes off running the football, I always hear people go, oh, he's sneaky athletic. No, he's athletic. Watch him do it. He's an integral part of the quarterback run game, and he gets it done very, very well.
Yeah, you don't like sneaky athletic, do you? That's
no,
just
not.
Kind of a jab in the back.
Yeah,
right?
Not when it doesn't apply. I think that's a stereotype that needs to be broken down for him.
And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard right on the 30-yard line. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with 3rd and still 7 yards to go. The play clock's running down. They toss it to Tomlinson. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? Was that 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Now a handoff here to his running back. Open space inside the 10. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here. We do have a flag down.
Get out of here. They got a hold on Vic's best run of the day. Oh, man.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And some room to maneuver. Down to about the 22 here. 9 big yards on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. They run with LT, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
In my book, that's
what I say. You got to win for her again.
With intelligence. About him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds.
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
Spinning call, hold halftime score. Oh, they did it to us, Lord.
So let's see what this is about. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up
again. Oh, why? Michael Vick just went through so much.
More condensed. Got to go back to their play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
Again, it's Tomlinson. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Time running out here on the play clock. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this.
We're looking for revenge. Ah, oh, 7-16.
Loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. As it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the 4th. Now they'll throw it. Wins.
Got him.
Receiving touchdown. Now this play, he just made it.
Yeah, boy. I won't jump by. Yeah, boy.
Route run there.
And Brandon, this is what the best receiver.
Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. And he is not going to get in there. He stops short of the goal line. And the lead is going to stay right where it is. This is taken at the 3.
Boy, I would have been made that speaking down.
Dial. One play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see when they decide to do a play caller. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't even save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second, it didn't even matter.
Flushed out.
Yo!
He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Brandon Graham in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally.
He's got a
man, God damn, why did I blitz? I thought you can do it, Rams. You let me down, my boy. You let me down, my boy.
2 yards. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this. I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up.
You the one I want in my life. You the one I want every night.
That's fielded in the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. Now a play fake here on first down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one good for 33 and a first. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. A handoff as they run the counter play. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. After that run, still a good amount of meat on the bone here for this third down play. Can you envision them putting this in the air?
Totally. I mean, look at who he has under center right now. If you can't trust him with the football, you can't trust anyone. And frankly, to me, I want the ball down the stretch. Get the first down, keep it in the hands of my offense. I don't want to turn it over to them and rely on my D.
And his kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
This is taken at the 3. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. Last time they were able to benefit a good field position led to a touchdown. This time they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I'm sorry, I think we're starting to lose Sean Tyler for a minute now. That shit's getting a little high.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Second and 10, Cunningham, he's going to let it fly, and the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
It's over.
Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
You know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
Back to throw, Cunningham. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven
down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see
how this
plays out.
Don't give him.
And the back goes into motion. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back.
Maybe a blue tree.
We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup, and these guys on your screen ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game, and speaking of the game, let's get right to it. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at his four. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Come on, baby. Come on.
There, it'll be second and six.
Starting off a little shaky here, a little shaky.
Play this call, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Doo-doo.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just run in there.
Oh my gosh, y'all all standing there. What are you guys doing?
He's up to the 48. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. So here we go, first and 10 now.
Together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
And now whistles and a flag.
Soon as turn on, that's when he want to do this shit. Come on, bro. He ain't do that shit on one fucking play to the hell.
He wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
Heck no, they let him glitch. They let him glitch out of that. Are you serious? Y'all tripping.
So they get the ball on the opening drive. They take it in for the score.
And how about setting the tone right away? But you always hear it in every locker room. First 5 minutes of the game, who's going to set the tone? Who's going to take control? Guess who just did?
Well, now on the next drive, when you score that quickly or you're scored that quickly again, it's probably feel like you need to respond.
Yeah, without a doubt. In other words, you've actually put the pressure even more so on your opponent.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line.
Get the hell up out of here, bro. Damn.
And let's listen in on the call. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Play action. Now wins. Brought in here by Tyler Eifert. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Here's Wentz to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Now Wentz on third down. Being chased out left. They got his man complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. They give him a gain of 38.
Nice movement there by Carson Wentz outside of the pocket. Completes another pass. Help me out here, partner. He's not sneaky athletic. He is athletic. How many times do I have to say it?
Yeah, you've been making that declaration for a while. And at 6'5", he ran a 40, a 4.77. So not only big, but he can move.
That's a good time.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. Often lack and sometimes call just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and score.
What? Oh, heck no, bro. What the fuck? Why did he throw it over his fucking head?
Now he'll be looking to duplicate the effort to drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
But you know how much much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big time races. Means they got out to a fast start. They're setting the pace.
He threw it over this nigga's head. Charles, for real.
Second down. I'm no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender. And he ended up making the play there.
Al Rogers underneath to Davis. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 5. And just like that, it's third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. It's caught, Nelson. And he brings this up to the 46.
That's not first down, bro.
The old connection, Rodgers to Nelson, getting Green Bay a first down.
Chief of dude. God damn, bro. This time your team, you guys gonna cheat like this.
Be a little careful, you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone.
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Throwing on second down. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit. And that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control.
How? Why are y'all not going all the way across?
Step up and make those throws, and he did that.
And they convert on third with a gain of 22. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Into the red zone. It's Rodgers.
Oh, you missed a pick?
Incomplete.
Dude!
1:58 to go in the first half of play.
Fuck, man.
We're back to Lambeau following these words.
I ain't making him miss no damn picks. I didn't do catch the impossible shit.
Rodgers again here on second and 10.
Why we can't catch that shit?
He dropped it in the end zone.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give him another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Rodgers to throw on third down. This is
dude's gonna be right there. What the fuck are you doing?
The defense is doing their best, but they're struggling right now. They'll look for some help from their own offense to keep them in the game.
Good to make it 14-0.
Pulls into a sorry ass dude. Come on, man. Damn.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken about the 12. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet.
Hey, hold on us, bro. What the fuck y'all want from us? We gonna let them cheat?
Zero off the board. So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap.
Damn, y'all didn't do cheat off the fucking blitz, bro.
That's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
Shotgun now for Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. He's gonna air it out deep for Green.
This nigga steady overthrowing this nigga like, damn, I know you see this nigga right here. Just hold, just throw the ball right.
Someone is certainly not gonna sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. Try to get it.
Throwing it over this nigga's head, bro. Hell no. Hell no. What the fuck? No. This nigga's wide open. Y'all letting this nigga do some bullshit. Well, this here man do no bullshit, now y'all tripping.
Charles and I set for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. We go from Lincoln Financial Field. This fielded at the two. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25. Play, but no more than that. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. He'll rifle this one deep right. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. The 20, 10, touchdown. Deshaun Jackson, 75 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
And it's good to make it 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field.
Fuck this one, Baba. Dog on.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell.
First play, first play.
22-yard line. It's a big run that time by Bell. 53 yards. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stops.
This nigga hold, he got there, man. So now I'm walking. He got to, bro. Because they're not letting me. He's like, no, everybody didn't block yet. 95, 4, bullshitting out here, man.
Second goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up. And sometimes you force a run a little bit, right?
And he's locked up, taken down, back at the 25. Brandon Graham, able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard. So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Throw it, Mariota. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to make it fourth down. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And they are on the board, but still trailing in 7-3. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. Let's field it at the 2. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line.
At some point, we're going to give it to our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Wentz going to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 36, and the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
This is such a good read defensively. They know that this offense is going to try to get the ball to their playmaker in space. So what do? They crowd him and send bodies at him. And this one winds up being intercepted.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. pushing forward for three up to the 48.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
On play action, Mariota. Just keeping the play alive. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And they're going to go for it here on the fourth down try. Mariota's going to stay out there. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. And this is incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be rude.
And he is dropped. Though we do have a penalty marker on the field. Let's get the call. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against him.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. A good productive run there on first down. He winds up getting eight. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step. That's big.
And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and eight.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47.
Come on, Dean Punk. Still want to do some shit.
Got some for you. Fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Wentz.
I threw it too far. Come on, Carson Wentz. Wide open, bro. You gonna do some bullshit like that?
Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for
hello. I'm about to come that way in a minute after this game.
But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one?
He still called it. Oh, come on, bro.
Plan going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much.
I'm on my way as soon as this game is over with.
Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do.
Holding.
And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Bell is so good at that. He just catches so many passes near the line of scrimmage. In fact, the unique stat line for him last year, he had more yards after the catch than total receiving yards from the line of scrimmage on the season.
That doesn't even sound real, but when you analyze his game, you understand why a stat like that can occur. His ability to catch the ball, be elusive, and also strong enough to break tackles, that allows him to gain all that extra yardage.
And I don't think he got in. The big bodies up front held him at the one. Officially no gain on the sneak. Kind of a wasted play there. And now it's third down. Ah!
Here's Bell. Yes! Swing out of that! And
this is picked up by the defense. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Okay.
We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. In tough starting field position here. And again this time to the tailback.
How did I get caught by somebody? Fucking block it.
I guess it's good we can't really read the mind of the defensive coordinator now, huh?
Had him pinned back there deep. In fact, that run can't be happy.
Yeah, whatever's in his mind right now, we probably couldn't say over the air.
Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9.
There wasn't a break out of protection. The running back not pick him up. What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing here is this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it.
Doing they supposed to blitz.
We're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here. They fake the give. Now win.
What the fuck? How? Lord, should I tell me how? That made me trip twice.
By the receiving team here. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head.
Why?
Here's Brad Wing now as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now a first down carry by Bell. And he's going to
find out. That cheating shit ain't going to go down, buddy.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Mariota now on second down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding
eventually he's taken down here. Great coverage downfield, resulting in a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Third and long here for Mario, and that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
So throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14. To throw is Mariota. Offense ready to head back out there. Well, what do you think? You get the ball off the turnover near the middle of the field. You take a shot here on the first play.
You know I'm big on that. I love when I have great field position after a turnover. I might have a little bit off balance. I prefer to take a shot, but a lot of coaches will tell you.
I can't make this shit.
Trust the guy who's got the football in his hands. Meaning, if it's not
that motherfucking field,
it'll turn into an interception. He'll go to the check down, go to a second option, and go take the ball that's in front of him.
A final shot before half for Wentz.
Just a little too far.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Sorry, Larry, your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance of this?
typically what they're doing is emphasizing the things
that are in the
first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
He glitching my Sean Taylor. What the fuck?
Third and four.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
Mariota from the gun on third down. He'll try and feel it work in the middle. And he'll get it up to
the
I
got a feeling.
Time and that'll bring up fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
They have a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. They'll run it with Bell. And he will have first down.
I messed up, man.
Yards on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson.
Oh, y'all can't keep that dude glitch the line like that, bro. He glitching Sean Taylor. He supposed to come down and smack him. Y'all got Sean Taylor missing on purpose.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more.
This nigga has 95 fucking pursuit. Probably more. Because I got him boosted.
Second down following the run.
And now they got him coming out slow as fuck, so I can't control him.
On the counter, here's Bell.
This one's fun with that shit. Man, he can fall all motherfucker at that too. That's another way I pissed off. He gon' fall. And when the time fucking comes.
Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll try and run for it with Bell. There they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 41-yard line. They lost two and
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here.
They let dude fit through there. All right, man, that was me. I would have tripped way back then if I even crossed the line.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. They'll run it now out of the gun.
This man.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? Take care of it. Rest of the game.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. DeMarcus Ware in there to drop him for a loss on the play.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Throwing is Mariota. Steps away to his left.
Man, I wish I would go get this nigga. Ah, shit. This nigga got all the time in the pocket, man. Lord. Shit, don't touch. He called it! This nigga is tired! Aw, oh, hell to the north, boy. This nigga's tired. Y'all gonna catch it? Oh, hell no, to the no, 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 to the no.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. give is to Bell. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Oh, you gonna Sean Taylor hit him, bro? Damn. And then they ain't gonna do a blitz like he was supposed to. Man, this ain't going down coverage.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. Here's Bell. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, Real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
Dancing to his left. And he's able to get this down.
Oh, fuck no.
Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
On third down, here's Bell. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. It's a pickup of three, but it brings up what will be an interesting fourth and one.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation.
Oh, shit. Stressful.
But the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Needing the tough yards.
They let him get it. What? I can't believe it. They just cheated us at the end of the game. Oh, hell no.
And his guys have taken the lead here in the fourth.
And now I can't go block his kick. Y'all just cheated us at the end of the game. This nigga got the push. Oh, hell no, bro. That was supposed to be turnover. Y'all just hold the fuck out of my team. Are y'all serious?
The
fucking EFO. I ain't taking the EFO, dude.
So out now comes the offense back on the
I can't
field.
Believe we just got a hole like that, man. Fuck the bullshit.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. Now Wentz. Trying to improvise. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Why did they let this nigga speed up? Oh my god, man. Man, that's ball, man. They let this nigga speed up. He got beat. Hell no, they let this sorry ass nigga speed up. Catch y'all another time, man. They cheating mud week again. One more game, man. 2-3. God damn, they cheating the fuck out of us, man. Every game I played, I got cheated like a motherfucker right at the end.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here after first and second down, went backwards. It's third and very long. Flushed out right. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
And look at this. They're keeping the punter on the sideline. They're going to go for it here on the opening drive. Throwing his wins.
They're going to stop him from running?
And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. A surprising move here on the opening
drive. Dude, a rat catch. Why did he stop?
The ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. And a great spot to start this drive from here.
Secure tackle. This nigga running through, dude. Hell no, bro.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. Eluding the pressure right.
Yeah, he would avoid the so he outran fucking. Alright, bro. He ain't outrun on Derrick Ray Lewis, bro. Come the fuck on.
This one a bit less, but it is a first down. Mariota on first down. Jackson's got it over the middle.
Supposed to peek there, right there at that shit.
That time. Knocked flat on his back. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. First carry for the five-time Pro Bowler, LaDainian Tomlinson. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a third and three. Security crew incomplete here.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it, and that's normal NFL football. They're gonna throw on third and short, but you gotta hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. So the opening drive for them here on their home turf results in a field goal.
Now that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you've got the ball, put points on the board first, and let everyone start to celebrate.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now this offense about ready to take over again. Throwing on first is Wentz. And caught right side, Green. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Wentz now on first down. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Buying time to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six. To throw Mariota. Being chased out left. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Portland in control of the football here to begin quarter number two. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. On fourth down on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. It's a 39-yard punt, three on the return, and the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. And now back out comes the offense. And not great starting field position here on the offense.
Today.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. Wentz now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. DeMarcus Ware. From his outside linebacker spot, he comes up to drop him for a loss of 10. Now Wentz throwing on second down. And he goes out of bounds across the 40-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. On first and 10, here's Wentz. Steps away to his left. And now the ball is near midfield. And the defense will get their hands on it, going the other way. And now off to the races, down the right side.
Man, fuck, dude, I'm getting home today.